As much as we were very hopeful that he would come out clean of it, we had a few discussions and we talked about things like going to a palliative care. And he always wanted to find out, what is this palliative care? Is he going to a nursing center and just being stuck there? So he had a lot of questions. And every time we had nurses come and the palliative care doctors come over, he would ask them. So we kind of discussed and we decided that we will stay home. So most of the time he was at home. He was in and out of the hospitals, but he didn't get a chance to go to palliative care. And we had already decided about the resuscitation also. And we knew that we are not going to go for that as well. I'd never been through a death in my family. So this was all new to me, even sickness. That's why for the longest time I was in denial. But then I don't know where I got this strength from, but I had discussed it with him when the doctor had mentioned. And I just casually asked him what he would like. And he told me that he would not like to be resuscitated. And then I did not have the courage to ask him on the day of, but before that, when the doctor wanted me to do the paperwork. But I asked my brother-in-law, who was his best buddy, to ask him. And so he told him that he would not like to go on the ventilator, because our doctor told us that even if he was to go on ventilator, he would still have cancer, right? So he knew that. So it was easy for us to decide about that, but it was hard to touch on that topic and talk about it. So my brother-in-law talked to him, and we went to the doctor with him. He was there with us. He was quiet, but I and my brother-in-law talked to the doctor and told her about our decision.